There are two types of programmers, and I believe that every single programmer can fit in between these two types. From your favorite influencers, all the way to your open source contributors. So, on one side of the spectrum, we have the craft-based programmer. And some key traits include caring extremely about code quality and maintainability, wants the most optimal solution to things, very much advocates for technologies that are tried and tested, willing to go extra steps to implement something on their own, is passionate about the craft of programming. And you often see the craft-based programmers as open source maintainers, low-level programmers, code reviewers, etc. The level of care that goes into this profession is often extremely selfless and goes unnoticed. If you have such passion towards the craft of programming, you want to be able to find the most optimal solution to make sure the code that you're writing is the most performant. And a good example is from the man himself, Linus Torvalds. After getting a pull request for networking code, Linus got annoyed about how overly complex the code was. Christ, people, this is just The conflict I get is due to stupid new GCC header file crap. But what makes me upset is that the crap is for completely bogus reasons. I mean, maybe annoyed is an understatement. There's a lot of programmers that are like this, but we'll come back to them in a bit because we're going to get to the second type of programmer. On the other side of the spectrum, we have the result-based programmer. Cares more about the end product, wants the most fastest to develop solution, can be experimental in latest and greatest technologies, happy to use existing solutions online, and is passionate about what the program creates. And you often see result-based programmers as startup employees, ship bros, content creators. The key here is speed, but not for you, but for me. Speed is the game. The programming is just another block that needs to be checked off that checklist. Often the priorities lie in hitting goals or creating something while maintaining it later on. These types of programmers often enjoy programming as a product of enjoying business or software. And there's many examples. One is Mark Zuckerberg with his infamous move fast and break things mentality, which in 2014 changed to move fast with stable infrastructure. Maybe he slid a little bit on that scale. Another example could be DHH, who advocates for programmer happiness and not over-engineering solutions.
Business, I can do whatever the hell I want, live wherever I want, buy whatever I want. That is a lifestyle, that's true. I think that's good.
So now that you know the two types of programmers, which one is better? Well, this is where the debate always happens online, and it can't ever be solved because we have huge competing philosophies. And of course, this isn't binary. It's a sliding scale. On the extreme end of the result-based side, you have prompt engineers who care so little about coding, they don't even want to write code. And on the other side, you have Terry Davis, who literally rewrites everything from scratch and only has one user he cares about, literal God. For me, I am a content creator. I am definitely more on the result side of things. I make videos and software purely for the entertainment of the viewer.
Hey there, Tony. I'm totally stoked to discuss capitalism with you. Listen, SpongeBob, you're a good kid. I get it. You're optimistic, you flip your burgers, and you think capitalism is this big Krabby Patty cook-off.
And to be honest, I would throw like 90% of the dev content creators on this side with me. Do you care about programming or do you care about software? When I was on Twitter a while back, I saw a thread that really defined these two competing philosophies absolutely perfectly. This tweet right here talks about the service Postmark, which helps you automate email delivery in your software apps. It mentions how after being acquired, the quality has dropped dramatically with an SSL certificate expiring, causing outages for most users. Then popular Twitter user Levels.io then said that they won't resend emails for 8 hours of downtime and that it would result in chargeback to his application. Then Mateo Kalina came in and said this, "This is the reason why we put sending emails behind a queue. If sending fails, those jobs would be queued up and be retried." Which Levels replied with, "Fair, but you're blaming the customer for a problem of their business. Last tweet, I promise. Ultimately, the service level agreement of your app is your problem. The vendors you chose is your decisions and trade-off." With email specifically, it's an absolute nightmare to deal with. So using a third-party app that has all these systems set up for you just makes sense as a result-based programmer because it helps you just get things done much faster. Although yes, Postmark is to blame for an outage, it's hard to justify to your customers that someone else did something wrong. So having to spend more of your time to create a backup of something that seems like it could never fail is counterintuitive to your philosophy of programming. Now, we see the pitfalls of the result-based programmer pretty clearly. However, the opposite end can have some negatives too. In 1997, Netscape released version 4 of their browser, and got started immediately on version 5, which ended up just going to version 6. With years of technical debt behind them, the team decided to do a complete rewrite of the source code to better optimize the browser. Issue is, it took forever, and it took 3 whole years to release the update. By then, their market share had crumbled. Optimizations that they thought people would enjoy went unappreciated because people just forgot about them. They were already moved on. Joel on Software says that it's harder to read code than to write it, which is a reason why programmers are quick to throw out their old code. At what point do you just say, you know what? It's good. Let's ship it. So throughout this video, you've probably seen one side as the absolute GigaJad and the other side as the Wojak, but there really is no better side in all of this. In fact, I think despite the clashing philosophies, a lot of the time they rely on one another. Hear me out. When speed of development is a high priority for the result-based programmers, you have to rely on the battle-tested software that has been optimized and fine-tuned for years and years. You can't just build a Linux, Redis, Django, SIMD, JSON in like a weekend. But for craft-based programmers, validation from users is also extremely important to constantly improve the software that you're building. When result-based programmers start using the craft-based programmers' projects, they're able to validate the features and help in terms of feedback for the projects in a real-world scenario. So in this script, I actually had a hot take where if you're using JavaScript, PHP, Python, or whatever dynamic programming language, then you automatically are in the result-based area. However, after being a bit more critical, I'm a little torn because it really just is turtles all the way down. If you run the sorted built-in function in Python, it's just a C function with a highly optimized PowerSort algorithm. If I were to make claims that a craft-based programmer would rather write it themselves, then I would be an idiot, and so would the person wanting to rewrite it, for whatever reason. So if we take the diagram right here, at what point do we identify the result-based programmer or the craft-based programmer? Can you have both that exist within the same level? Could we literally take our scale, flip it 90 degrees, and then just paste it there? I don't know, maybe. This is where all of this kind of comes with a bit of irony. The result-based programmer has become a valuable market opportunity. Take email. It's terrible to implement, so companies offer to handle it for a monthly fee. You just write 2 lines of code and move on with your day until it's broken. But here's where things get very interesting. Look at Astral. They're building Python tooling in Rust, like UV and Ruf, which embodies this craft versus results subject. They're using Rust, which traditionally is craft-based, to make better tools for Python, which traditionally is result-based. And while they're open source, they've raised $4 million in venture capital. They're using deep technical craft in order to build products that are faster for result-based programmers to program in and ship faster. So it's interesting for sure. So if this was a scale, where would you fit in all of this? Let me know in the comments. And if you agree or disagree with my whole entire analysis here, then please let me know in the comments why. React to it, whatever you want to do. Peace out, coders.